Cosmetic surgery is an exploding industry, especially in Southern California, the glamour capital of the world, where ads for plastic surgeons are just about every place. Rhinoplasties, or nose jobs, are among the most common procedures, but sometimes patients get uncommon results. Gina Silva explains.
Is this where they do the surgery?
Sarah Stephenson has wanted a nose job for years, and she's finally going to have one. In this home video, Sarah says she was feeling goofy and so excited, all smiles as she trapped on the operating table. And before she knows it, the surgery's over. As soon as Sarah looked in the mirror, she had concerns.
I noticed that my nostrils were extremely visible and that my tip was almost gone.
And when the bandage came off,
I was very, very scared. I didn't recognize myself.
The more time passed, the worse she felt about it.
I pretty much locked myself in my house for 8 months. I lost my faith for 8 months.
Jesus, it's a really bad day. It's just like gone down a lot. Towards the end of the day, every time I look in the mirror, it's just really hard.
Sarah is not alone. Thousands of patients go looking for a nose job do-over, or what's called revision rhinoplasty.
9.2 million cosmetic surgeries were done last year here in the United States. The number two procedure after liposuction is rhinoplasty, but because it's such a difficult procedure to do, complications do arise. In fact, medical stats show that 12% of all nose jobs end up having to be redone.
It's not that uncommon that I see patients. They're just devastated by their results.
These two doctors, Dean Toryumi from Chicago and Jack Gunter from Dallas, are considered among the top revision rhinoplasty specialists in the world. Before and after pictures of their patients are often used at medical school programs and rhinoplasty conferences. These surgeons even learn from each other's cases.
Rhinoplasty is one of the most difficult operations we do in plastic surgery.
Their practices are full of patients like Sarah who come to see them from all over the country.
When you've had surgery, there's a tremendous amount of scar tissue, and that scar tissue distorts the normal anatomy.
Among the complications Dr. Toryumi has had to address after other doctor's surgeries, droopy tips, crooked noses, and saddled bridges. Dr. Gunter showed us some of his cases too. This woman's severe tip deformity, this man's disfigured nose, and this girl's overly upturned nostrils. Rita Cervantes got a nose job 6 years ago to remove a bump on her nasal bridge. But she not only didn't like the cosmetic results, she was left with a serious breathing problem.
I'm not looking to be perfect or anything, but it's just...
A tough subject for Rita to talk about. She often regrets having picked a doctor based on a radio ad. An experienced rhinoplasty revisionist here in Los Angeles, Dr. Paul Nassif, is about to perform her corrective surgery.
We're dealing with a patient that feels they've been damaged, or they're damaged goods. And it's very, very, very intense.
So how do you avoid needing a nose job do-over?
The patients aren't doing their research on the physician.
A few good places to start... Choose a board-certified plastic or facial plastic surgeon. Check with the medical board online for any lawsuits or disciplinary actions against the surgeon. And communicate with other patients, either in person or on websites like this one designed for people to trade information about doctors' results.
It was just one of the most devastating things that I've ever had to go through.
Gina Silva, Fox 11 News.